Hello friends, welcome to Tech Dose, and in this video I will show you what are the differences between bubble sort and selection sort. So let us begin. So the first point of difference is, in bubble sort we do compare and swap, while in selection sort we pick the correct element in one scan. So what is compare and swap? In bubble sort you must be knowing that each element is compared with its adjacent elements. So 5 will be compared with 3, and suppose we are arranging all the elements in ascending order, okay. Then 5 will be compared with 3, and whichever is smaller will be placed at this position. So 3, since 3 is smaller than 5, so 3 will come here and then 5 will go here. Then again we compare the second element with third element, and since second element is smaller than the third element, so we will do nothing. We move on to the third element, and so on. So this goes on. This is how compare and swap works. In the selection sort, we start from the second element, that means we start from the next element, and then scan all the remaining elements and see which element is the smallest of all the elements. So since 2 is smallest of all the elements, so this 5 will be replaced with 2 and 2 with 5 in one iteration. So in the bubble sort you can see that after first iteration 3 and 5 will be at the starting locations, but here 2 and 3 will be at the starting location. So this is our first point of difference. Let us see the second point of difference. The second point of difference is about the time complexity. So in the bubble sort we have order of n time complexity in the best case, and in the worst case it is order of n square. But in the selection sort we have order of n square time complexity for both the best and the worst cases. So how does this happen? Let us see. In the bubble sort algorithm, the best case occurs for the case when the elements are already arranged in the given order. That means the input elements are already arranged in the order it is asked to be arranged. So suppose we have the input elements as 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and we are asked to arrange in the ascending order. So these elements are already arranged in the order in which it is asked to arrange. So the time complexity for this algorithm will be just order of n. So how does this happen? The first element will be compared with the second element, and since first one is the smaller than second one, so nothing will happen, no swapping. And second element will be checked, second is smaller than third element, so no swapping. Like this, no swapping, no swapping, no swapping. Okay, so here we use a swap flag which is always set to 0 before each iteration. And if there is no swap in a iteration, then we assume that the elements are already arranged. Okay, so this is how it works. And this is the worst case input for the bubble sort. The elements are arranged in the reverse order in which it is asked to arrange. So suppose the elements are arranged in the descending order and it is asked to arrange it in ascending order. So what will we do? We will just compare the first element with the second element, and since the first element is greater than the second element, so it will be swapped. So this will be 5, this will be 4. Now the second element will be compared with the third element, and like this, if we do first iteration, then the result will be 4, 3, 2, 1 and 5. That means the highest element is pushed to the right. And again we have to do bubble sort for all these 4 elements, and then for 3 elements, then 2 elements, like this. So the time for this will be order of n square, and in the time for the above case is order of n. So how does the time complexity is order of n square for selection sort in both the best and the worst cases? So selection sort is a type of algorithm which doesn't have a best or the worst case. It will do the entire scanning for a single particular input, that means for a single particular number. So suppose these elements are arranged in ascending order and we are asked to arrange it in ascending order, then bubble sort would have given us order of n time. Let us see what does this give. That means a selection sort algorithm. So the first input is 1. We will compare with the remaining elements, that means 2. Is 2 greater than 1? Yes, so nothing will be done. 3 is also greater than 1, so nothing will be done. Nothing will be done, nothing will be done. That means the purpose of our scanning was to find a number, that means the smallest number, which is smaller than 1. So since there is no smaller number than 1, so it will be skipped, and this element is already at the correct position and we will start from this element. So now for 2, we will start scanning from 3, and since 3 is greater than 2, we will move on to the next element like this. So it will always be n square time, even in the best case. That means even if the elements are arranged, it will be order of n square time. And suppose we are given the reverse inputs, then what will happen? For the reverse input case, the same thing will be happening. And for 5, suppose we will start scanning from 4. So since 4 is smaller than 5, so this will be considered. Okay, now we move on to the next element. Since 3 is smaller than 4, so this smaller element will be updated to 3. Now we move on to the next element, and since 2 is smaller than 3, so this will be updated. That means the smallest element will become 2, and then since 1 is smaller than 2, so the smallest element will become 1, and this 1 will be replaced by 5. So after one iteration, the value will be 1, 4, 3, 2, 1. So this is how selection sort time complexity works. We are doing exchanging in bubble sort algorithm and selection in the selection sort algorithm. So exchanging means we are just comparing the adjacent elements, and if certain condition is satisfied, then it is exchanged. But we are not sure that the elements are put in their correct position, because after that again a scanning will happen and again the elements can be moved. But in the selection sort algorithm, all the elements are scanned and the most appropriate element is picked. Most appropriate element is picked and it is put to its correct position at once. Okay, and no change of position will happen after it is put to its correct position. So this is known as selection. And the next point of difference is that bubble sort is somewhat slower than the selection sort. Even though I told you that the best case time complexity is order of n and worst case is order of n square, and in selection sort it is always order of n square, but while implementation, that means practically, it has been found that bubble sort algorithms are somewhat slower than the selection sort algorithm. Bubble sort algorithm are stable sorting algorithms and selection sort are unstable sorting algorithms. So if you want to know more about stable and unstable sorting algorithm, then please hit the I button which is shown above. The stable sorting algorithms actually maintains the order. That means if two elements with the same key, that means suppose 2 and 2, that is two elements with the same key are occurring in an array or a list, then the first element will always come before these two in the arranged array. If you are not following this stable sort and unstable sort, then please follow my video. It will be very, very clear. The stable sort versus unstable sort. I have taken the same example of bubble sort versus selection sort there. So if you like this video, then please hit the like button and subscribe for more such videos. Thank you.